Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please sing together, I love you, Lord. Because we are sorely hindered by our sins, let your bountiful grace and mercy speedily help and deliver us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Zephaniah. Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you so that you will not bear reproach for it. I will deal with all your oppressors at that time, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. At that time, I will bring you home, at the time when I gather you, for I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth, when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thank
We will read Canticle 8 responsively by half verse. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense.
And you will be my Savior.
Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing
from the springs of salvation.
And on that day you shall say,
give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name.
Make his deeds known among the peoples,
so that they remember that his name is exalted.
Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things.
And this is in all the world.
Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy.
For the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, it is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The work.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Please stand and sing together, Draw Me Close.
Let me go.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
John said to the crowds that came out to be baptized by him, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruits worthy of repentance. Do not begin to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our ancestor.' For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children to Abraham. Even now the axe is lying at the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire." And the crowds asked him, "What then should we do?" In reply, he said to them, "Whoever has two coats must share with anyone who has none, and whoever has food must do likewise. Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they asked him, 'Teacher, what should we do?' He said to them, 'Collect no more than the amount prescribed for you.' Soldiers also asked him, 'And we, what should we do?' He said to them, 'Do not extort money from anyone by threats or false accusations, and be satisfied with your wages.' As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, 'I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I'm not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire.' So with many other exhortations, he proclaimed the good news to the people." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. It was hard to get any traction with the scripture this week. And I preached on it a lot of times, and I heard a lot when I was a kid, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee the wrath to come?" Great hellfire and brimstone lesson, right? But as I wrote down notes, they came sparingly. And then this morning, I was looking at my desk, and I saw this, right? I've used it before in sermons, children's sermons. Let's see. And it just keeps going up and down, right? And it's called Jacob's Ladder, right? Isn't that amazing? I mean, it's not too amazing to some of you rocket scientists. But when I look at it, I think, well, how do they do that, right? And sometimes I think this is the way my life is. I don't know whether I'm coming or going, right? Y'all ever feel that way? Like you, especially this time of year, right? You're trying to get everything done. Too much, too many things to do. And then you'll think of something to do in the midst of all this, and you'll forget what it was you were fixing to do to begin with. And you know, in the South, we're the only people that can say that, right? Fixing to do something, right? Now, as I looked at this thing and I thought about this, I thought about what had just happened to me. That's often my sermon comes from what just happened to me. I saw something I needed to cut with scissors, and so I got the scissors, and I finished using them, and I thought of something else I needed to do. This time of year, that happens a lot. You know, we got so many things on our mind, and we got to do this, and I thought of something else, and I thought, well, I better get rid of the scissors. So I tossed the scissors at the table in the workroom, and sure enough, they hit the wall and went down behind the table. That ever happened to you? And then I decided, well, I better get the scissors. And so I pulled the table back, and it was at the last place it could be, as far away from the front of the table and the side of the table. And so I got down on my hands and knees, and there was two boxes between me and the scissors, right? And I reached over, and I almost couldn't make it. And then when I finally got the scissors, they were flat against the wall, right? Now, I know, I may be the only one that's ever happened to you, but have you ever dropped a coin or a ring or key or something, and it always bounces and finds itself in the furthest way, place away, underneath something you couldn't possibly have got there if you tried, right? Has that ever happened to you? And you reach, so then you have to go get a coat hanger or something to get it, right? I think that sometimes our life is like that. We're reaching way high. And I told the kids a story this morning about the Christmas tree out there. You notice it doesn't have any ornaments on it at all. And there's always an ornament to put on top, right? It's a star or an angel or something. How do you get it up there, right? And, of course, the kids, I said, have the parents ever baked something really special and they put it up high so you couldn't get at it? And while they weren't there, you got up on a chair to get it, right? And then I said, have the parents ever told you not to get up in a chair? And, of course, you've all heard that, right? Don't get up in a chair. And they said, well, you do it anyway, don't you? I said, but now here's the other question. Have you ever seen your parents get up in a chair to get something? And they all said yes. And we do that sometimes. We forget where we are, and we're reaching high for something that's unattainable, right? This is the third Sunday of Lent, Gaudet Sunday, which is Rejoice Sunday. The day that we rejoice, John the Baptist comes into the room and says, "Repent, you brood of vipers, who warned you to flee the wrath to come." Well, that doesn't sound like a rejoiceful scripture, does it? So I had to look a little bit harder, and I read Philippians, and Paul says, "Rejoice always." I say again, rejoice, and let your kindness be known to all. I think that's what he says. Let your gentleness be known to everyone, right? Now, this time of year, it's hard to find people that are acting in gentle ways when you go out shopping, right? You're out to get that last thing that you just know will make things perfect, right? Reaching a little bit higher for perfection. And you go and you're about to get this perfect item and somebody comes up and snatches it right in front of you. And there it's gone. And you're looking again for the happiness that you deserve, right? By getting everything perfect. This time of year when we're trying to decorate, we want everything to look perfect, or maybe we want to cook that perfect meal or something we saw in Southern Living, some dessert, and we're going to make that, and we're going to maybe trim the tree ourselves like I did yesterday to surprise Trudy when she came back from Denver, and I was on the ground trying to get this thing right, and it fell over. The tree outside, right? And I'd already put water in it, and the water's all on the ground. I'm in water. And I'm sitting there trying to get this thing righted and unscrewing the screws to put it in so I can screw them back again. And I'm thinking to myself, what an idiot. If I had just paused, I could have got somebody to help me, right? But no, I'm going to do it myself. And when we do it like that, we end up with scrapes and bruises and sometimes saying things that we probably regret saying around people, we regret saying them around. Let your gentleness be known to all. As I thought about that this morning and looked at this Jacob's ladder, I thought about another picture that I used to see, the M.C. Escher pictures, right? Where it looks like you're not coming or going. You don't know if you're coming or going. Because when we live in the world, that's the way it is. And in this story today, we hear from John the Baptist, who's out in the wilderness, and he's talking to the people that come to him, and he's calling them a brood of vipers. And the people that ask him, what can we do to change this story, are the outcasts, the soldiers, the tax collectors, and they're all wanting to know, what can we do? Because the people in the in crowd are the ones that are telling you, if you just reach a little higher, you can get that happiness you deserve, right? What can we do? And here's what John says. He says, repent. You got two coats? Give one of them away. You got more food than you need? Give that away. Be content with what you have. And don't try to get one up on somebody else. And live in a world where your gentleness is known to all. And the good news, this is the good news for the gospel tonight. Jesus Christ came into the world as a little child. I was listening to the radio this week, and I was listening to some of the invitations to come to church by some of the preachers. And in today's world, right, we're trying so hard not to offend anybody. The preachers don't even mention Jesus in their invitation. They talk about God, but they won't talk about Jesus. Jesus is the reason we're here tonight. Jesus is our way out. Jesus knows the way up and the way down. And if we'll follow him, he'll lead us to that happiness that we deserve. And that's good news. Let's stand and say the historic creed of the church, the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. And he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified and upon the cross of God. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge us the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
The Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son, and with the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and all of the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in it and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commit to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The confession. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you. God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Peace. Jason. Please be seated. Welcome. Good to see all of you here tonight. We started out slow, but we filled it up, didn't we? Okay. It's been a great Advent so far. If you were here last week, you heard the most wonderful presentation of lessons and carols that we've ever had, and we're going to even have better in the future. And one of those times will be Christmas Eve, 5:30 and 10:30 here. We'll celebrate Jesus' birth, and at the 5:30 service, the kids will have a little pageant. So come to one of those services, and if you feel so moved, park in the fields because it'll be crowded. We gave away all the presents. You notice they're all gone. And we were even able to help a family who wouldn't have had Christmas without us from someone in the parish that knew some neighbors that had really bad times. We gave away all those turkeys and Thanksgiving meals at Thanksgiving. And we have done a lot of good things to help others in our community. There's more to be done, though, and you can live into what John the Baptist talks about tonight by finding ways to give every day, okay? Now, one of those ways you can give is to the staff. We have envelopes, they call special envelopes. There's some special gift envelopes out there, yes. And you can give some money, put that in there, and we divide that among the staff for Christmas to let them know how much we care about them. We have Wing and a Prayer this week. That's Tuesday. We have an art guild. Did y'all come last week to the art show? The art guild meets Wednesday, I think, or Thursday this week. I think, is that all in the bulletin here? Yeah. Okay. And if you want to decorate for Christmas, call Susan Wolcott. Tell her you want to help, and she'll put you to work. And if you want to donate a poinsettia for Christmas, there are poinsettia donation tickets out there, and do that as well. And next Sunday is my birthday, right? Now, I don't want any presents, right? But what I want is presents, right? I want your presents here. I already lost the Barr family. There's six of them. Now, here's the deal. I want you to bring four people that you know could use the love of God through Christ Jesus, right? Four people, right? Now, because the bars are going to be gone, that's six times four, 24 people extra that we have to bring. So if you want to bring six people next Sunday, do that. But that'll be your presence for my birthday, right? Bring some people here to church that could use a church family. And if you do that, it'll make me really happy. No presents, but presents. Got it? And ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name, bring offerings and come into his courts.
Thank you. and of thine own have we given thee.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ and bring us to that heavenly country where with St. Matthew and all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray.
Give us
are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. 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 Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us. Peace of God that passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Let's sing together forever.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.